That looks pretty firm. Can I flip it without it falling apart? Oh! Hi everyone, I'm Roberta. I'm a registered dietitian nutritionist. I worked in the hospital for 25 years and now I work somewhere else. But the reason for this video is I want to show you or start showing you what I eat for breakfast, lunches, and dinners. After getting this Invisalign about a year ago, my eating habits have changed because those of you who have Invisalign know you have to brush your teeth after every meal. And I definitely was not going to be brushing my teeth 5-6 times a day. So I took all my calories and divided it among 4 equally spaced meals. Well, I came to find out that there are some endocrinologists or diabetes specialists who also recommend that you take the calories that you need for the day and divide them evenly into 4 meals spaced about every 3.5 to 4 hours. So if you're looking to lose weight or maintain your weight, maybe this will give you some ideas how to keep it organized. So the first step is to figure out how many calories you need. Perhaps you found a registered dietitian in your area that you can work with. You can look at one of the videos, this video that I did on figuring out your calorie needs. But it's always good to work with a dietitian who can look at your health history and see what is best for you. When I took the different calorie counts, 1200, 1400, 1600, 1800, 2000, and I was thinking about the idea of 400 calories per meal, because that's what I have to do. And well, this is the one where you don't have 400 calories the entire 4 times, you just have it 3 times. Here you have 400 calories at the meals and then a snack of 200. This is what I do unless I'm exercising. 400 calories 4 times a day. You could take this and divide it into 2 snacks. Then the 1800 calories, if you need that for weight loss, you can see how you can divide the calories that way. And then you see here 2000 calories would be 500 calories 4 times a day. So when I show you later on what I eat for 400 calories, those of you who know how to add just 50 or 100 calories more, either through nuts or seeds or an egg or 1 or 2 ounces of chicken or fish. I would like to show you what I tend to eat, 400 calories each time, and maybe it'll help you with whatever calorie count you need. The way that I plan my meals is I use the plate method, where 1/4 of the plate is protein, 1/4 of the plate is carbohydrate, and 1/2 the plate is vegetables. Well, you'll see, I don't always get 1/2 the plate in vegetables, but I try to have vegetable at lunch and dinner. I don't always have that at breakfast. Here is a more detailed way that I visualize my meals when I'm putting them together. I think about 20 to 30 grams of protein, or 30 to 45 grams of carbohydrate, or keeping the fat to no more than 10 to 15 grams of fat. These are all the things that I'm thinking about when I'm putting my meals together. Can I show you what I had for breakfast on Saturday? So here's what I made, pretty simple to make because I'm not that great of a cook, and I want to explain the ingredients that I used. So the Pam cooking spray, I used just the olive oil one because the original Pam has a little bit of palm oil in it, and palm oil makes my cholesterol go up. Then I used baby spinach, but if you don't like spinach, you could use onions, peppers. And then the egg whites, I'm using egg whites from Costco because the fat is mostly going to come from the avocado. So that's why I wanted to use the egg whites, where each serving is, 3 tablespoons for 25 calories. I'm going to use 2 servings. And protein is 5 grams, so I'm going to use 2 servings of this. So if you don't like egg whites, then you could find something else that would give you a total of 50 calories. I'm going to use the Thomas's English Muffins whole wheat. It has about 120 calories, actually less calories than the other Thomas's English Muffins. I like these because the fiber, there's 3 grams of fiber in the whole wheat. If you don't like English muffins, get something else that's about 120 calories. And regarding the avocado, we're gonna use 1/2 the avocado, has 10 grams of fat for 1/2 the avocado. Then a serving of fruit. I picked these up at Costco. I never tried them before, I wanted to try them, and they're very convenient. 60 calories in each pouch with 3 grams of fiber. If you'd rather just use a fresh piece of fruit, just get something that gives you 60 calories. And lastly, I'm going to put some collagen in my tea. This collagen I bought on vitacost.com. It says 2 scoops is a serving, but we're not going to use 2 scoops. We're just going to use 1. And that will add 9 grams of protein to the breakfast. I'm a big tea drinker, and so I'm either going to have the green tea or the decaf black tea. I'm not sure yet. So if you're making a shopping list, get out your pad of paper, cooking spray, spinach, egg whites, whole wheat, English muffin, avocado, fruit, and collagen. I already set the heat to about a medium high, so I know you don't need to spray a nonstick pan, but I like to anyway. I'm adding a nice handful of spinach. A cup of spinach is only 7 calories, so add whatever amount you feel like. It'll take a few minutes, of course, for the spinach to wilt. So while we are waiting, I am using a T-fall pan I got at Target and a silicone spatula so I don't scratch the nonstick. I don't usually use nonstick pans. However, when I'm making eggs, they always seem to stick to my stainless steel pans. So to help that spinach wilt, let's press that down with the spatula a bit. And when it's nice and wilted, let's grab the egg whites. Again, we're going to be using not just 3 tablespoons, but 6 tablespoons to give us a total of 10 grams of protein. So that's 1, 2, 3, we need 6. That's 4, 5, and 6. So once the edges start to look a little firm, I'll scrunch it toward the center. Let the liquid slide down to the sides so it'll cook better. I'll scrunch it up to the side there, let the liquid come down to the side a bit. Now, if I can do this, I know you can, because I am not the most talented cook, but I do know how to calculate all my calories and nutrients. So you'll be seeing some very simple meals coming up in the future. Let's see how it looks underneath. That looks pretty firm. Can I flip it without it falling apart? Oh, not too bad. Most of it held together. So I'll just turn that heat off. There's a lot of heat on that burner, and let it finish cooking. Oh, something I forgot to do. I wanted to add some onion powder. This is onion powder, not salt. So put some onion powder and some garlic powder. Again, this is powder, not salt. So some onion powder, garlic powder. And I'll just let it sit there, put that on the back burner, and just let it sit. Next up, we just need to grab our English muffin, cut it, and put that in the toaster. Again, if you don't like English muffins, this English muffin is 120 calories. Just grab something else, bread, gluten-free bread if you are doing gluten-free, but something that is about 120 calories so that in the end the calorie count will be similar. So let's get our English muffin from the toaster. And grab our eggs. Now, how do you want to do this? Do you want to put the eggs? We got the avocado, yes, but how do you want to do the eggs? Put it on the English muffin, or let's just flip it and I put it on the plate. This way I can just put the avocado both on the English muffin and on the eggs. So I was concerned how the avocado was going to look on the inside. All the avocados were a little soft in the store, and it's getting some dark spots there. No problem. We'll just cut those away. While I'm doing that, while I'm prettying up the avocado, if you want to see more videos like this, please give it a thumbs up so I'll know that showing you what I eat and the calorie counts is something that you want to see more of. And if you want to be notified when the next video comes out, just hit that notification bell and you'll be notified when the next video comes out. And subscribe if this is something that you find helpful. What I think is cool is if you currently are not subscribed, when I say the word subscribe, I think that it lights up on your screen. So look at that little subscribe button and see if when I say the word subscribe, there are little colors that go around it. I think that's kind of cool. Okay, we've got our avocado on our eggs and our English muffin. We just have to have some fruit or something that's 60 calories in the way of fruit, and we're going to put the collagen in the tea. Grab our mug, and I'm going to have some decaf black tea. Regarding the collagen, we're not going to use 2 scoops like it says a serving is, just 1. And I'm curious to see if the scoop is 10 grams. So let's turn that on and change the units to grams. And let's see how much is in that scoop. Okay, not quite 10 grams. Can we hit 10 grams exactly? Yay, 10 grams. We don't want collagen to be our only source of protein because it's lacking in tryptophan. So we can use the collagen as a source of protein, but it's recommended not to have more than about 15 grams of collagen in a day. And there's our meal, which you could actually have for breakfast, lunch, or dinner. The calories are only 380 calories, and I've listed the fat, saturated fat, sodium, carbs, fiber, natural sugar, added sugar, and the protein, because everybody's looking for different things. So thank you so much for watching. If these are the kinds of videos you want to see more of, give it a thumbs up. Hit the bell notification if you want to know when the next video comes out. And for all my Michigan fans, go Blue!